So 71 there are. And how about that? It's Barry Watson straight to the front. He told me he was going to start steadily. He's got a very heavy cold. So too has Jeff Norman. But he's gone off straight away in front. Barry Watson, who really cherishes the British vest that he's wearing. He's worked as a club athlete for 15 years to win that. And he's even been training in it most days. He's so proud of it. Watched in the stadium today by his wife, four-year-old daughter Madeline back at home. Been looked after by his in-laws. Bengtsson of Sweden in second place. Incidentally, the marathon's been held since 1896 when the games were revived. The Greeks became a bit depressed as the titles, even those which they regarded as their national speciality, such as the discus, were won by foreigners. But happily, the last event of those 1896 games, the marathon, was dramatically won by Spiridon Louis, a post office messenger from near Athens. Now into the back straight and off they go. And Barry Norman said he wanted it hot. Well, he certainly got it humid today. Bengtsson of Sweden leading. And Watson right there. No sign of Virren showing at all, or Frank Shorter. In third place, Gotskii of Russia, wearing a white vest, discarding the darker Russian vest. So Watson of Great Britain leads and waves on the way as they go on the road around Montreal. It's a slightly severe climb as they approach the 5,000 meter mark, and Lassie Virren right up there with the leaders. The two Americans, that's the champion, Frank Shorter in front, the Olympic champion. Just in this area, very, very sharp climb for a short distance. If we got a wider shot of them, you see the way they're digging in. Virren obviously tracking Shorter, staying with him, probably thinks he's the danger man, and seeing that Virren hasn't run the full marathon in competition, certainly at this level, we don't think he's run a marathon before. He certainly won a half marathon a short time ago. Virren obviously settling for his pace judgment on Frank Shorter's experience. Lismont of Belgium, the Farron Europe, the former European champion, just see his head bobbing between Virren and Shorter. Can't see any of the British boys yet among that leading pack, but there's a lot together. They're just at the 13 kilometre mark. And the time at 10 kilometres was still very fast if Ron Hill's listening back in London. They went through 10 kilometres at 30 minutes, 48 seconds. The rain still falling gently, and the leaders and fancied runners all there. That's Pinto, who's just been dropped slightly, but there are 18 or 19 in the leading group. Just a word about the pace from Ron Hill in London.
Well, it's still under 5-minute mile pace, which means under 2:11 for the complete marathon if we keep this up. One can't help feeling with a bunch of that class at the head of the field, it's going to be the last one in that wins the race.
So gradually they're being whittled down. Chiapinski a moment ago just snatched a slight lead at the feeding station. He was the only one not to grab a bottle. He got about 5 or 6 yards, but they cut him back very quickly. That's Bill Rogers alongside him. Bill Rogers, oddly enough, numbered one in this competition, and many of the Americans fancy him to take the title off the holder, Frank Shorter, his teammate. They're approaching 28 kilometres, and Chiapinski, the East German, tucked right in there with Frank Shorter. Singh is closing up again as well, and back in the London studio, no doubt watching absolutely fascinated is Ron Hill. Just the one European there at the moment, and it looks as if they've got away from Virren, well away. Not enough information in that shot to tell you, but it does tell us where we are. We're just about 27 kilometres, Ron.
Yeah, I'm not surprised Virren has gone. I thought he might crack about 30 kilometres because he hasn't had time to go on the diet, and of course a special glycogen loading diet helps run us through from 30k up to 40k without feeling any very bad effects.
Just about 6.5 miles left. These leaders already through there. Chiapinski just tested Shorter a moment ago. The rain absolutely coming down in straight lines. They're well away now, these two, but it's Chirpinski at the moment who's looking the stronger and just shorter hanging on. This is the second attempt. The East German's made a break in. We could be at an important point of the race here. You can see how much he's really driving on. And Chirpinski now beginning to get away. Shorter, the Olympic champion, must know that unless he can get back with him, he's in trouble. That's the shot outside the stadium, very close to the Olympic Park. And this, the leader, Chirpinski, well away apparently now from Frank Shorter and within sight of the stadium itself. And he comes now within sight of this vast crowd. He looks around, wants to know what the time is. It's up there on the big board, and he can also see himself. The first time any athlete's been able to run the final lap and enjoy it by watching himself. Frank Shorter now coming into the stadium, the Olympic gold medalist, who's failed so narrowly to do what Abibi Bikila did, defend the marathon title. Meanwhile, the new Olympic marathon champion has 300 metres to go, as Shorter is about to enter the stadium.
Frank Shorter, it has been United States.